One challenge that came up a lot is how to overcome the mind's argument that the spiritual seeking is not worth it because of the inevitable suffering and depression that follows in its wake. The depressions that visit me are so consuming that I find myself cursing all the spiritual work I've done, because in these dark places I feel like I'm fighting to stay alive. Can you please speak about this tendency of the mind and of the inevitable contraction that is married to this expansion I feel? Again, you describe how these golden moments are becoming the cross that we have to carry in our Via Dolorosa. There is absolutely nothing wrong with reality. It is our constant stumbling and clashing with it that creates suffering. Maybe it's too early in this retreat, but let's give it a shot. You know, every path, every spiritual path is at first is to destroy everything that we know, to burn it in the fire of confusion, so the new understanding can be born, and then awareness that will maintain it. What would be a healthy destroying that we could have here? Very humbling, very ego-shattering destruction. Not something that we could go and brag about. But it would be if we all come to the silent space in which we realize that we know nothing, that all our knowledge is hindering us and is functioning like a blindfold over our consciousness. Depression. What is depression? Such a term that we are using and is so charged with a negative context. What is depression? And who says that it's negative? Who is the one that taught you that depression is negative and that you need to fight it and it is not good for you? The commercial in the TVs that showed you that smiling is the right way to live and sadness is wrong? The Hollywood movies that always end up with a happy end? When was it that we started to believe that bliss is good and depression is bad? In fact, if you take from this experience that you call depression, take the title depression out of it. be that experience without this title that we are giving it and is already carrying generations and generations of judgment. Just be the experience without the title. Then what? What is depression? Lack of vital energy? That you don't find a reason to wake up in the morning, to get out of bed in the morning? What is the problem with depression that we are trying to get away with it, away from it? Why we are working here, we can walk for years about transcending judgment. We are trying to be compassionate to others, not to judge them. And also there we are getting very confused between what is seeing and what is judging. Yeah? But that will live for another. We're trying to be compassionate, not to judge. But when we are lacking energy, and depression is basically an absence. It is an absence of joy, it is an absence of vital energy, it is absence of a drive to go ahead and be driven by a strong sense of purpose. It is an absence. And so, suchness, absence is happening. So be it. Not one person in this world, and I can promise you that without testing it, has surrendered to the so-called negative phenomena that we call depression, but truly surrender to it and didn't transform it. Wholeness is wholeness, whether you are whole in sadness, in pain, in pleasure, in laughter, you are one. You are this experience. There is no duality, there is not this judge that is deciding this is good and this is bad. When you disappear into what is happening, when you are one with what is happening, the one that can label it and the one that can try to change it or to be attached to it depends if it's a negative or a positive experience according to our preconceived ideas. The one that is trying to change it is not there. You are the absence, you are the joy, you are the sadness, you are the pain, or you are the pleasure. Who is there to judge it? But what happens if we surrender to it, if we disappear into it? We, as we know ourselves, cease to exist. We, as the personality with all the ideas about what life should look like, about which flavor my energy should have, that it should be joyful, that it should be very vital. some kind of perfectionism. Let's look into our heads, let's have a window over into our head and see what kind of dreams we have about ourselves. Very few here will have a nearly perfect ideas, all the rest will have very perfect. Very few people will have here human expectation. What is depression? Comparing this to other flow of energies that we had passing through us in the past? That this was nice, this is how I want it? The problem is not in what is happening, the problem is that you want it compared to something that happened in the past. We are creating the problem, it is not in the experience itself is suchness. Let go into it, be it in its totality, fearlessly, trust in it, disappear into it, without waiting for it to transform itself, without waiting for it to change. It's not about stepping into it with a calculative mind. Okay, I will surrender into it and I will wait for it to change. No, when you surrender, when you become it, there is no one who is waiting. Then suddenly something starts to happen. Life is a continuous change. Heraclitus says you cannot step in the same river twice, because it is continuous flowing. Osho said you cannot step in the same river even once. Go figure. One moment you are lacking energy. Be it. Suchness has its beauty. You are breathing life energy. No resistance, no duality. Low energy. No sense of purpose. No reason to focus our ambition on. No ambition even. So be it. Why to make a problem out of it? But we never allow life to happen. We're in continuous control over it. Some energy, some emotion that we are not sure where it will take us is bubbling up. We are doing something about it. Who are we to do? What is wrong with it that we are doing something about it? Some energy is bubbling up. We run away from it. We light a cigarette. We go to chit-chat. Go eat something. We do something to control it. Sadness is coming. We judge it as bad, as a problem that needs to be solved. And like this, we never explore life in its fullness. We never really go through the lesson in its totality, because we are always avoiding, we never allow it to reach the natural climax. It comes, we are afraid. Where is it going to take us? To the unknown? I don't like the unknown. I like what I know so far, what is familiar. We want truth that is in the unknown. Until it's knocking on our door, then we stay attached to what is familiar to us. Sadness is happening, let it be there. Open your eyes, fasten your seatbelt and see where it's going. depression is happening, no reason to wake up in the morning, no reason to get out of bed. Make sure that you get pipa near your bed, some cold water, and let's see, how long will it last? How long before life will take you out of bed? Not you, because you should and you're supposed to. What if we can erase everything that we know about how we're supposed to be and how we should be and what's supposed to happen? What will happen? First, a freak out. We will look for something to orient ourselves with. First, a freak out. And then freedom. Whatever happens, let it be. Freedom is divine made. It is not man made. You don't need to do your life. You don't need to design your emotional flow. And you don't need to design the level of your energy. And you don't need to design the purpose of your life. That's how free we are. All we need is to be aware that we are not trying to be in control, and to see how it is passing through us. One moment, there is no reason for you to get out of bed. Okay. The next moment, you are so full of energy that you find yourself running and up and down the hills, hugging trees, not knowing what to do with it. William Black said, energy is delight. Yes, energy is delight. But it is constantly changing. One moment there is no energy, and it is just, it is nothing but a preparation for an overflow of energy to happen. When an overflow of energy happening, it is a preparation for a drought moment. This is life, the yin, the yang, the night and the day. The polarities that are making wholeness. All our ideas that we are having about it are wrong. We cannot grasp it with our minds. Our minds are partial, and this is wholeness. Our minds exist in duality. Our being is silent. But we insist to live through the filters, through the glasses of the mind. So of course we choose the day, not the night. The joy, not the depression. The pleasure, not the pain. And then when life itself is happening, because there is no choice, but it has to happen, has to be so. How can the yin exist without the yang? How can the feminine exist without the masculine? If there is no masculine, then the feminine is not feminine. It defines itself according to the opposite. So we are dividing our life, certain that we know what is good for us, that depression is not good for us, and we're giving a lack of energy such an unfair title, And then there are companies that are making billions over this misunderstanding. It is not a problem. It is nothing to solve. It is life. And reality is never wrong. So our suffering is not caused by reality. It is happening because we misinterpret it. We misunderstand it. And the funny thing is when we hear stuff like this, it's like, yeah, now what shall I do? Strong habit to do. Don't do. We've done enough. Be. And be sure. That it doesn't mean that you will be floating continuously in La La Land without roots in the ground. Because, look, this whole village is not a reflection, is not born out of doing. It happened. I didn't do it, neither did my fellow travelers. It happened. We allow life to pass through us, and we found ourselves creating it, sometimes I look and it's overwhelming. I couldn't do something like this. It would be very flattering that people, sometimes people tell me, wow, what you did, what you created, you fulfilled a dream. I didn't do anything and I didn't fulfill any dream. It happened. So, having no purpose and no ambition, and seeing the mind as an instrument, doesn't mean that we have no ground and no roots. In fact, this is where life is keeping its perfect balance between the top, the treetops, and the roots. It is the intelligence of life passing through us without us messing up with this. It's scary not to have problems, huh? Reality is reality. It can make us comfortable, it can make us uncomfortable. No. Fair enough. Being in a human body, in an imperfect reality, luckily it's imperfect, so it can continue to grow and change. If it would be perfect, no movement, it is dead. So in this imperfect reality, there are moments of comfort, moments of discomfort. The suffering belongs to us. We take off the glasses of misinterpretations and it disappears. Om Shanti.